after years of research, speculation, and theories, we finally have the confirmation that the Zonai will be ascending within that of Tears of the Kingdom. Within the gameplay demonstration by Mr. Aiji Aonuma, we finally got the confirmation and connection of the Zonai when it comes to the Sky Islands and the technology that's found there. While this may seem like something small, things will never be the same again when applying what we know from Breath of the Wild into Tears of the Kingdom. This video will explain why, and when the dust clears, you're going to be as hyped as I am. What's up, Zonai believers? It's your boy HMK once again with another Zelda video. We're really going to dive into the noise with this one, so be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe to HMK. Remember, if I hit 200k before Tears of the Kingdom releases, I'll give away a collector's edition, multiple copies of the game, and more. So, let's dive directly into the noise. As a bit of a primer, this confirmation came out from Link defeating a construct within the Sky Islands of Tears of the Kingdom. There, it dropped a soldier construct horn and a Zonai charge, which contains the familiar green energy we've been seeing throughout all the trailers these past few years. What seems to be the same energy powering Link's arm, the Zonai creations, and the seal that was keeping Ganondorf at bay that was indeed broken. But who exactly are the Zonai? Well, the TLDR is that the Zonai are a mysterious tribe that has disappeared from the chapters of history that were referenced in whispers within that of Breath of the Wild and expanded dramatically within that of Creating a Champion. They were known to be savage, warlike people, but at the same time, sophisticated, strong magic users. Their architecture can be seen all over Hyrule within that of Breath of the Wild and are heavily featured within that of Tears of the Kingdom. And now it seems that the truth behind this tribe will finally be revealed in this game. And when I say truth, I'm talking about this mysterious energy source that is being utilized by these machines that we see in the Sky Islands and Link's new arm. What exactly is this power, and how did the Zonai come to utilize it? Is it the power of the gods? Is it a divine power that is directly connected to that of courage? Similar to how it is speculated that the Sheikah technology is utilizing the power of wisdom? Is it somehow connected to Twi'li energy or that of spirit magic? These questions were unclear in Breath of the Wild, but I'm sure we're going to have them answered in Tears of the Kingdom. And of course, we have to talk about the machinery, the constructs. These are machines that are eerily similar in concept when it comes to being powered by this energy, like the Sheikah Guardians were powered by the Sheikah technology and energy. Was this power and technology feared in the same way by Hyrule as the king and the kingdom feared the Sheikah technology 10,000 years before that of Breath of the Wild? Or was this technology a precursor to how the Sheikah based their own technology on? And when it comes to the Sheikah technology, specifically the Sheikah Slate, it granted its wielder specific powers known as runes, such as bombs, stasis, magnesis, cryosis, and the camera and amiibos and yeah. But even still, it seems that these powers acted as successors to the powers that are granted to Link within that of Tears of the Kingdom, which include the powers of Ultra Hand, Recall, Fusion, and Ascend. Are these the powers and abilities that are staple to that of the Zonai tribe? If so, these powers exemplify more in line with that of creativity rather than savagery, which is one account of how they're referenced in the past. And with one such power of ascension, it may be possible that the Zonai have always been connected to that of the sky. And then we come to that, to the direct relation to Ganondorf. Now that we know that the Zonai are truly the ones behind that of the seal on Ganondorf within Tears of the Kingdom, how did this come to be? How and why did Ganondorf get sealed by the Zonai? What are the Zonai's connection to that of the royal family in aiding them to imprison the King of Evil? If they're the ones that are truly responsible for putting the seal on this terrible evil, then why was their history nearly eradicated from time itself? I believe that the truth will finally ascend within that of Tears of the Kingdom, and that in itself may attribute to the name of this game. But as we look towards these answers, prepare yourself for the HMK content that's coming out on Zelda Tears of the Kingdom every week going into the release. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like, share, and most importantly, subscribe to HMK. Until the next one, I will check you guys later.